Hey, I'm Jonathan Sewell, sales at Mitchell Mazda on the Boulevard in Enterprise. And today I'm going to be talking about some onboard technology to the Skyactiv-G 2.5 liter, and that's the cylinder deactivation technology. So I was first reminded of this by a viewer on a video a few, a couple months back. And so I've spent some time researching it, looking at a few more things, and also doing a drive test. So we'll jump into that in just a minute and see how it works, why it works, and then of course why it matters, or why it's a benefit to Mazda owners and Mazda drivers. So before we jump into all those things, of course, go ahead and click the subscribe down below, and don't forget to always ding that bell so that you'll be notified first of all new videos about Mazda. So before we jump into the driving and experiencing the cylinder deactivation, a couple things I want to go over with you first. The first thing is how this system actually works. So I borrowed a little bit of video from Mazda, and as you can see, as the cylinders are firing, they have a little bit of a rocker system there that can automatically, on these outside two cylinders, can switch with just a moment controlled by the computer, and can move that piston where it allows the same momentum from the crankshaft, but no firing of those valves, or no valves with air, and no firing of fuel. So that allows these outside cylinders to not fire, saving fuel economy, and of course reducing power, but this is only used in a light load situation. So pretty neat how they've instilled that. Now also, a couple of things that I may have not shown on the drive, but when you're sitting still or idle, the indicator is all lit up with all cylinders running, even though you're not under a load. Just as it's idling here, everything's going. There's no need to have those cylinders running. So it's definitely just when it's moving, a light load system or situation. So that's something that I may not have mentioned on the drive. So let's jump into that drive and show you how it works, and talk a little bit about why it works, and then of course at the end of it, hopefully you'll see why it matters to you. So before we can view the cylinder deactivation, from the home screen here with the medallions, you have to, with the commander, scroll over to applications, and the fuel economy monitor is what we're going to look for. I'm making a turn here, and we'll begin shortly with testing this out. So the first step here, I'm going to go manual, and what I mean by that is with my foot controlling or trying to adjust the cylinder deactivation. As you see, it just went from 4 to 2. And these are county roads with a little bit of bumps and vibration, so I hope you can see this clearly. So on this first fuel economy monitor page, you see the four cylinders there. So under regular load, your engine will be acting on four cylinders. The second identifier here is when you're under a light load, it would show two cylinders, just like that. And how I'm doing that is just barely touching the accelerator on this, for the most part, straight path. Now, I'm about to go down a hill, and when that happens, the engine's gonna be under no load, because I'm basically coasting, and so it's gonna go completely off, or no cylinder showing. And it also happens when I let my foot off the accelerator, it would do that. So, and you see now that we're going back up the hill, it requires all four cylinders to be under a load as well, which is probably, you know, going up this incline above normal. So these three indicators will show. Now, now I'm not skilled enough or good enough with my accelerator pedal to keep it on this mode right here of two cylinders for very long, because it would take an extremely level terrain to be driving on, like I'm just experiencing now. But then if I push the accelerator even slightly, a little bit too much, it would jump back into four cylinder mode, because it requires to, again, a very light load to be in two cylinder mode. So you can try this on your CX-5, and the hard thing, of course, is to get it balanced out where you can ride in that two-cylinder mode as much as possible. Now, in the two-cylinder mode, and I'm driving just over 50 miles per hour here, but on the two-cylinder mode, let's say at 25 miles per hour, which is very rare that someone would be driving 25 miles per hour continually, unless it was like a school zone or something. But at 25 miles per hour, when you can get this into that two-cylinder mode, you actually can improve your fuel economy by almost 40%. So if I was able to drive around in this mode, I can improve my fuel economy at almost 40%. The downside is that this two-cylinder mode with such a light load and such a very slow or very slight depress of the accelerator, it's not enough power to keep the vehicle moving. What I mean by that is with weight of the vehicle and friction of the tires and all those things, you will slow down in that two-cylinder mode. So it's hard to get where you're going in a timely manner, of course. And then 25 miles per hour, you wouldn't be accomplishing much average speed, unless, of course, you were in a speed zone that required that. Fortunately, when you go twice that speed at 50 miles per hour, you still can get a up to 5% increase in fuel economy. And so most of us are going to drive in that 50 miles per hour range and achieve that 5%, which may not sound like a lot, but over a day, weeks, months, years, it would make a dramatic difference on your fuel spend or your fuel budget. So this is, again, on the Skyactiv-G, one way that Mazda is improving the driver experience. Now, it is kind of a lot of dew this morning, heavy clouds, but as you can see, the sun just broke through, so there's going to be a little bit of a glare. I am about to turn up here, so it'll change on us. Now, as you've seen as I've been talking, it's hard to stay in that two-cylinder mode, as I was saying. So on this next leg, for the next little while, I'm going to turn on the cruise control and see how the system or the computer can help out. Now, we know that cruise control is always going to help you get better fuel economy when the computer controls the accelerator and the gas usage. So I'm going to use cruise control. And right now you see below the average since reset at 26.9. Let's see, I'm gonna run this cruise control and speed through the next 8 or 10 minutes and see if we can get that up to 27 just in the next 10 minutes from using cruise control. So change the fuel economy by a tenth of a mile per gallon. So I'm gonna set my cruise control at 53 miles per hour and let the computer handle all the changes in the cylinders and deactivation. And so I'll set that now that I'm at speed. at 53 miles per hour on cruise control. And again, I'm gonna let this run for the next 8 or 10 minutes and speed through this so you don't have to sit for 8 or 10 minutes. And you can just see how the screen changes. Like right now we're at two cylinders, and let the computer control that by controlling the accelerator. Okay, I actually came to a stop to make a turn about 5 minutes in, so but I hope you noticed there at I'm back on manual control since I just haven't set it yet at a little bit higher speed limit on this road. But I hope you could see that one reason that keeps in two-cylinder mode so much is when you're above the 53 miles per hour, you know, with hills and different things, as it was kind of just letting the car go back, slow down and go back. Due to weight, friction, etc., it was in two-cylinder mode, so that allowed a little better fuel economy. I did not yet get to the 27 as I was hoping. Probably another 5 minutes or so we'd get there. I am, as I mentioned, on a little bit higher speed limit road, so I'm going to adjust that to 60, and setting that now. So in the next couple of minutes, we'll see if I can jump to that 27 miles per gallon there from help of the cruise control and the cylinder deactivation technology. Go around this person here. The Mazda radar cruise control was slowing down a little bit for this car in front of me. So keep in mind that this came as part of this engine. It is, however, available on all CX-5s and several other products with the 2.5. Now I know that a couple of the, like the entry level Mazda 3 does not have this. I'll have to double check with the CX-30s. But I'm pretty certain that the Mazda 6 will have it across all models. So if you have a 2.5 liter, you can click in and check out the this fuel economy monitor here. Now while we're going down the road here, and we'll come back to the screen in just a minute, I did want to show you the other option. Here we can click and change to the next screen. And this actually tracks more of a bar graph of what we're doing here. And so you can see that although my average in driving this vehicle was 26.9, on this drive, I'm actually getting 31.7. So with use of the cruise control and the help of the cylinder deactivation technology, I'm getting 31.7, which is actually higher than what the EPA reports on the window sticker. Of course, I am on highway, so you'd expect it to be on that higher range, but I'm actually doing better than that, and this is part of that driving or driver's experience that Mazda wants to help improve. So it's pretty pretty cool here that's coming through, and I'm about to come to another stop here, or light. Okay, I've resumed my cruise control on 60 miles per hour, heading right on through. Not much traffic on the road this morning since it is the weekend, so that's good. But this is the Mazda cylinder deactivation technology, and I hope that you've learned a little, but maybe also been influenced on how to get a little bit better fuel economy. And this is kind of technology that was first, well, I had forgot about it. I've only been with Mazda a couple of years and forgot about this when I took some certification on the Skyactiv G, some certification modules, and was reminded by a viewer on a few videos back a couple months ago. So decided to look more into it and provide this video. And you can see we're kind of not quite coasting, but we are in two-cylinder mode as we go down. So let me minimize this and see. Oh, look at there, 27 miles per gallon. So there we go. So I appreciate you joining me with this look. And if you have any additional questions, you can always drop them in the comments below. I try to always respond to those as quickly as I can. Sometimes a few get missed in the shuffle there, but try to be vigilant and respond to those when they are fresh. Also, you can always call or text me at 334-718-0504. I am Jonathan Soul Sells on my way to Mitchell Mazda on the Boulevard in Enterprise. I'm in Enterprise now. And I can't wait for you to experience this cylinder deactivation technology in your new Mazda. And of course, this is just one of those benefits that Mazda throws in for enhanced driver owner experience behind the wheel. So I can't wait for you to experience it in your very own Mazda.